HDR is high dynamic range, and the high dynamic range in the context of video is quite different to the HDR that you may see on your phone. Pull the phone out, go to take a photo, it seems to default to HDR, you can turn it on, turn it off. HDR in a photographic sense is essentially bracketing photos for dark, for light, and then blending the two together to optimize dark and light portions of an image. HDR in video, on the other hand, is talking about the dynamic range, which can also be described, I guess, as contrast ratio from the darkest portion to the lightest portion in any given scene. There was some work done by an amazing man, actually Netherlands-based, by the name of Barton, that resulted in the Barton model. The range that the human eye could actually see was far in excess of what we were being delivered in video systems. And the contrast ratio that was that the human eye can perceive in any given scene is about 10,000 to 1, which from photographic sense works out to around about 14 stops. The dynamic range that our eyes can see in absolute terms without just one scene to the next is actually more like a billion to one. It's huge, about 30 stops. Standard dynamic range was never actually a term, of course. Standard dynamic range is something a little bit like a sequel to a movie. We never put a one behind the title of a movie. We only ever call it that after two comes out. So standard dynamic range, SDR, we really coined that phrase once HDR came out, because it just gave us that relative reference back to what was. And it's only talking about somewhere in the order of 5 or 6 stops rather than 14. So it's very limited, very restricted. HDR is about giving us what the human vision is capable of seeing in a scene reference point. And it must be from capture, the content itself. It needs to go right through the workflow in HDR and be displayed on an HDR capable device. So be it a projector or LED TV, whatever the case may be. The player, in fact, the source, whatever the content is, be it streaming content, UHD Blu-ray, there's a bunch of different sources, will actually need to be HDR compatible, and in fact the right flavour of HDR too. There's quite a few different versions out there that are competing with, or in fact doing different things. So the end goal is actually very much the same. The starting point for HDR and the model that's developed to deliver what the human vision is capable of, they're all about doing the same thing. With HDR, HDR 10 Plus, there's HLG, Dolby Vision, there's a bunch of different ones. They actually can coexist, but the market will determine what happens. But we do need compatibility of content and all devices in the chain to support HDR. HDR is about delivering us what, if technology allowed, we would and should have had all along. And it's about trying to reproduce whatever it is that we're pointing a camera at and representing that in a display accurately.